Hi guys, in this video we're gonna cover your clutches which falls under your power transmission. Which still falls under your power transmission. Now, the function of a clutch is to connect your driver unit driven shaft in such a way that it can be able to engage and disengage. So this is just a function of your clutch. We're gonna cover many types of clutches. As you can see here, there are four groups of clutches. There are positive clutch, friction clutches, centrifugal clutches, and hydraulic clutches. So these are the three categories of clutches which we will cover. Now we're gonna begin with the positive clutches. So the positive clutches is the first one here. They call it the positive clutches because it gives the positive drives. There's no slippage that takes place. So they call it your positive drive because there's no slippage that's gonna take place on your positive clutches. In other words, the slippage, when you're dealing with a clutch, it's a process whereby your drive and the driven shaft are not going in the same speed. So you call it a slip. The moment whereby your drive shaft is not going in the same speed or the same revolution as your driver shaft. So it's a slip. So your positive clutches has no slippage. So when your clutch engages your drive shaft and your driven shaft, oftentimes they're going with the same speed. Hence we call them your positive clutches. Let us look at the types of a positive clutch that we'll cover. Now, these are the types of positive clutches: your square claw clutch, your spirit claw clutch. So in this section, I can see I covered all the types of clutches. The second one is your friction clutch. Your friction clutch, they call it your friction clutches because there is a friction that will take place on a component of a clutch when it engages. So it will engage by means of a friction. But we're gonna see when you're looking at friction clutches. Centrifugal clutches, those are the types of centrifugal clutches which you're gonna start when you're looking at the centrifugal clutches. But the name again is taken from the centrifugal forces that occurs when it engages. Then hydraulic clutches, because it uses hydraulic fluid. But these are the four groups of clutches and the type of clutches that we're gonna cover under each group. Let us look at a first type of a positive clutch. This is what is called your square claw clutch. Other textbook will say it your square jaw clutch because of these jaws that you can see there. These jaws, these are jaws when it engages. This is your shaft, your driven shaft. This is your driver shaft. Why I say this is your driven shaft? Because of this lever which disengages. The function of this lever is to pull it back there when you pull it out from your input shaft. So this is just a type of a square claw clutch. They call it your square claw clutch because of these jaws that you could see there that are square in shape. Now, these are the advantages of your square claw clutch. Let's look at the advantages. It transmits torque without slip. In bolt, they have written the main weight there. Effective for slow moving shaft carrying heavy load. It's suitable for driving both directions. So your square clutch can be able to drive in both directions. Then to get a disadvantage, the machine must almost stop before engage takes place. So it can engage at a higher speed. You can see in design that it's impossible for it to engage at a higher speed. But this is just your square claw clutch. These are the advantages and then one disadvantage of your square claw clutch. Under your positive clutch, the second one is your spirit claw clutch. Now again, this is your how it looks like. This is your driven shaft. This is your drive shaft. This is your lever which pulls your drive shaft from your driven shaft. This is your spring which provide your thrust load, which pushes your lever, your shaft to your driven shaft to your driver shaft. So it provides your axial forces and then ensure that it engages with your drive shaft. So this is your spirit clock clutch. Because of these spirit shapes that you can see there, this is, so still fall under your positive clutch. And then let us look at the advantage of this spirit clock clutch. It uncouples automatically when a direction of rotation is changed. So this type of a clutch only drives in one direction. Should it happen that the drive changes direction, it will automatically disengage. Now, the disadvantage of this shaft is only that it's driving in one direction. So under your positive clutch, you have that square and your spirit claw clutch. The difference between the two, your square claw clutch can drive in both directions, and then your spirit claw clutch drives only in one direction. You must know the advantage and disadvantage, and then the structures you could see. Now, this is fall under your friction clutch. So meaning we're entering your friction clutch there. This is a common type of a clutch because it's one that you use most of the times in your motor vehicle. You can see this is where you have your pedal there. This is your driven shaft. This one mounted on your gearbox, this driven shaft. This is called your lay shaft there, which is your input shaft into your gearbox. This is your flywheel, if you look carefully. This is your driving shaft. This is drive shaft, it's your crankshaft. So it mounted there on your pistons, this one, your driving shaft. Now, there is a pressure plate there on the side of your driven shaft. There's a clutch on the side. There's a flywheel on the side of a driving shaft. In between, there's a clutch plate. This is to provide the friction. So when you disengage, your resistance bearing, your thrust bearing will pull your pressure plate from your clutch plate, releasing a pressure between your clutch plate and your flywheel on the other side. So when you push a pedal there, as you could see, when a pedal goes forward through the spines, your thrust bearing will pull your pressure plate backward from your clutch plate, meaning there's no friction that will take place. So your clutch plate is loose there. Now, it means you're disengaging. If you press your pedal, your thrust bearing push, your release bearing pushes, pulling your pressure plate from your clutch plate, releasing a pressure between your flywheel and your pressure plate, meaning there's no engagement takes place. If you release your pedal, your thrust bearing again will push your pressure plate towards your clutch plate. Through friction, it will engage there. So the engagement takes place due to friction because of that clutch plate in between your pressure plate and your flywheel. There's that clutch plate. So those are the three main components: pressure plate, clutch plate, and your flywheel. But this is the general structure of your single clutch friction, your single friction clutch. Let's look at the advantages and disadvantages. Advantage of a single clutch plate, these are the advantages. It transmits power at a high speed, can engage while the machine is in motion. Unlike your the positive clutches where you must stop or you must almost stop your machine for it to transmit, for it to engage. You can engage and disengage while it is in motion. It slips if it's overloading. That is one of the advantages. Shock is eliminated during engagement. Disadvantages due to that slip. Disadvantages of your clutch, it's not suitable for use in a heavy load. Now, let us look at a multi-disc clutch. It is the same as your single disc clutch, only that on this type of the clutch, you have more than one clutch plate. You could see there, you have, those are the clutch plate inside there. So you have more than one clutch plate. That is why they call it multi-disc. You have your clutch disc more than one. And you can see this one is more compact than the other one. This is your input shaft from your crankshaft. And then obviously the other side, it's your drive shaft on your gearbox. So this is how it looks. Your multi-disc is still your friction clutch. Your engagement takes place in terms of a friction, but you have more than one disc. That is why they call it your multi-disc clutch plate. Let's look at the advantages of your multi-disc, it is more compact. You can see the diameter is smaller there. If one disc fails, it will still continue to function with the other disc. The other one rely on one disc. If it fails, that means your clutch will fail. But this one, because it has more than one disc, it will still engage. It have a longer lifespan due to the slippage than the other clutch, and then great power can be transmitted. The disadvantage of this clutch, more surface on which slip can take place, higher initial cost, and then that is the last one. Then when you're looking at the next clutch is your cone clutch. Now, this is, if you look at this clutch, you can see that it's conical in shape. This is just your orthographic view. You have this driving shaft mounted on this outer cone, and then, I mean your driving shaft, so meaning it's your crankshaft. This is your driven shaft on your gearbox. So this is called your female. These cones, this is your female cone, this is your male cone, and then that is where they mate. Where they mate, there's this friction lining, so it takes place due to this friction, which will take place. Now, when you press your pedal, you could see that it will pull your cone backward, disengaging your outer cone into your inner cone. So as it engage, and then when you release your pedal here, there is a spring which will push your cone toward your inner cone, toward your outer cone, and then they will mate. So this inner cone is your female, this outer cone is your male. It is on your driven side and your driver side. So because of this cone shape, it called your cone clutch. Then this is one, and you can see the larger contact area, so the engagement takes faster than the other friction clutch, so it quicker than the other friction clutch because of a larger contact area, this cone clutch. Now, this clutch oftentimes slip. Let us look at the causes of a slip of this clutch. These are the causes of a slip. I've written them down there. With if there's an oil in your contact area, faulty adjustment or operation, and then glazing on the friction surfaces due to continual slippage. Now, how we can fix those slippage? By removing your grease, test it regularly, rub your contact area. Let us look at the next clutch, which is called a centrifugal clutch. This is a structure of a centrifugal clutch. Now, you must remember that your centrifugal clutch is separated into two. You have a fixed weight, and then your loose weight centrifugal clutch. This is a structure of a fixed weight centrifugal clutch. Now, I didn't put your loose weight. I only put this because the structure is the same. The only difference, the other one doesn't have this spring. This one have the spring. Now, if you're looking at carefully this at this clutch, there's this drum outside, and then there are those spiders, and then these are called slippers. The one that has a spring there. Now, this spring hold your driving shaft away from your driven shaft. Now, they call this a centrifugal clutch. This is a drive shaft at a center there, as you could see. This is your driving shaft. Your driven shaft is mounted on this drum. Your driven shaft. So you have your drive shaft there, and then your driven shaft mounted on your drum there. As you can see on your side view of this, this is your driven shaft, this is your drive shaft inside there. Now, this is your drum. If you're looking at carefully, they are not mounted here. These are slippers. The slippers are being held by this spring. Now, when you rotate this weight, which are called slippers, as you rotate it, there are forces which are generated, which are called your centrifugal forces. The centrifugal forces are forces which are generated on a weight that are moving on a rotary movement. So if you have a mass which is rotating, there are forces which tend to push this mass, these masses outside. And those type of forces are called your centrifugal forces. Now, it is because of the centrifugal forces that this weight, which are called tipas, will go outside. As they go outside, if these centrifugal forces overcome the weight, this spring, the forces of this spring, that means it will be forced to go outside, and then they will meet, or they will meet with this drum here. So this friction lining will be attached with this drum, meaning because of the friction that will take place, the engagement will take place. So this is called your centrifugal clutches. Those centrifugal forces will push your slippers outside, and then they will meet there because of the centrifugal forces. Now the function of the spring is to keep this weight away from your drum until it reaches the acceptable speed. So once it reaches that speed, the required speed, that means your forces of a springs will be less than will be less than the forces of a weight, and then it will be pushed outside, and then it will engage. That is your centrifugal clutch. But this is the structure of your centrifugal clutch. This has to get the advantage of it. Act as a safety load, overload, no engagement shocks, reach full speed quickly, smaller motors and switch gears can be used. So these are just the general advantages of your centrifugal clutch. Now the last one is your hydraulic clutch. Now, this is just the simplest type of a clutch. Why? Because of a lower part, of a fewer component. You can see this is your driving member. This is your driven member, meaning this is mounted at a motor, and then this is your impeller, and your follower. There is a fluid inside this housing. Now, when it rotates, this one, your fluid will also rotate, causing your centrifugal forces, and then it will be forced to go outward, and then your centrifugal, because of your centrifugal forces, it will ultimately go on your same speed. I've tried to make an example on the other side here on your left. If you could see here, if you can move this fan, this other one is not mounted in your power. If it rotate, this, because of centrifugal forces, this one will also rotate without you putting this into power. So in this case of hydraulic clutch, there will also be centrifugal forces developed by the rotary movement of your hydraulic fluid. But because it generated because of hydraulic fluid, we call this hydraulic clutch, taken from a hydraulic fluid inside your housing. But this is just a simple structure of your hydraulic clutch. It has your driver, your driven, your impellers there, and your fluid. Very simple type of a clutch. These are the advantages and disadvantages of your centrifugal clutch. These are the advantages: simple in design, as I've told you, smooth and quiet operation, operating cost are low, and then speed variations. And then the disadvantages of a centrifugal clutch, here are they. I've written down parts and seats can be damaged if exposed to bad weather, corrosion, dirt, and deterioration of a fluid. You know the viscosity of a fluid is important when you're dealing with your hydraulic clutch. So this is the last one, your hydraulic clutch. So we've covered four groups of clutches. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much.